What's happening, guys? Keith here with your June 10th edition of the Impact Report. So if you haven't checked out my review already of this past week's episode of Impact, you can do so by clicking the little icon at the top of the video. So speaking of this past week's episode of Impact, it drew 296,000 viewers and ranked 119 on Cable's Top 150. This is up from last week's 283,000 viewers, so good news there. Last Monday, we had the Slammiversary press conference where we learned that the Grand Championship is no more. Aries commented saying, "The Grand Championship in its inception was under a different regime, with different rules and a different outlook on the championship titles. Really, once the Grand Championship was put on Josh Matthews, it pretty much had zero value at that point. So I tried to bring a little bit of life back into it, but I think that we all agree at this point there just needs to be one world champion." So we also learned that Johnny Impact and Taiji Ishimori will return for Slammiversary. Johnny was off filming Survivor during the April tapings and was absent from the June tapings due to his wedding with Taya Valkyrie. So I think the biggest surprise is the return of Taiji Ishimori. He has been working for New Japan Pro Wrestling for the last month or two, where he competed in the Best of the Super Juniors tournament. He had a great showing and made it all the way to the finals, where he was defeated by Hiromu Takahashi. A lot of speculation going on now that this is the start of a partnership between New Japan Pro Wrestling and Impact Wrestling. If that is true, that would be fantastic news. Also during the press conference, SC Scoops spoke to Don Callis, and they asked him about Canadian wrestlers and which Canadian wrestling prospect he would like to sign. His answer: "There is this young Canadian kid I like. We'd love to sign him. His name? Kenny Omega. Another is Chris Jericho." Right now, it's kind of hard to envision these two men in the company, with Kenny Omega just winning the IWGP Heavyweight Championship this past weekend at Dominion, and Chris Jericho still not sure if he's ever going to wrestle for another promotion in North America, as he still has very close ties with WWE. We also learned that, or from the Impact on Twitch Twitter page, that there will be a live behind-the-lights Slammiversary pre-show. I'm not sure what time this will start, but I'm pretty sure as we get closer to Slammiversary, a time will be announced. It looks like all the VIP and front row tickets have sold out for the event. I went on to shopimpact.com earlier, and the only available tickets were 4 second row tickets and general admission tickets. This is great to hear. I don't know if you guys had checked out, but Andre Corbiel was on Robert Does Wrestling's podcast, and he spoke a little about the Rebel Complex and what an awesome place it is, and it's going to be a very different atmosphere. So if you guys have a chance, go check that video out. Robert Does Wrestling's YouTube page, I will leave in the comment section below. It was also announced that Impact Wrestling has signed a TV deal in Mexico and will broadcast on Canal 52MX. Impact will return to Mexican airwaves on Saturday, July 7th at 9:30 p.m. Impact had previously run on the network back in 2008 as TNA Wrestling. Eli Drake did a short television commercial promoting this. I will leave that in the comments section for you guys to check out as well. So good things for Impact there, expanding globally. The Zero Fear One Night Only show that happened last weekend will debut on the Global Wrestling Network this Friday, June 15th. I ran down the card on last week's episode of the Impact Report, and it looks like it's going to be a great show. Madison Rain and Don Callis will be joining the All-In show September 1st. Madison Rain is a competitor, and Don Callis will be a commentator. So it seems like that show will be streamed, but no announcement yet. The Rise of the Knockout special that will air on Twitch July 7th has had a few matches announced. Sue Young will defend the Knockouts Championship against Soraya Knight. Tessa Blanchard will face Chris Wolf, and Madison Rain will face the Fallen Flower. They will also crown the first ever Guardians of Rise Tag Team Champions in a Four Corners Elimination Match. The four competing teams will be decided at Rise 8 on June 29th through a series of tag team qualifying matches. That is a Twitch event I am very much looking forward to. And speaking of the knockouts, Alicia Edwards was featured on this week's Impact Wrestling teleconference. She kind of talked about the knockouts division and the whole feud with Eddie Edwards and Sami Callihan. So these things really aren't in order, but I feel like I'll just give you, you know, talking about one segment at a time. So speaking of the women's wrestling, she says that women's wrestling has come a long way. She's been wrestling for 10 years, and when she started, WWE was having bra and panties matches. It's incredible what it looks like now. She says the knockouts division is the best it's been in years, but ultimately her husband is her number one priority right now, so she doesn't have knockouts title ambitions at the moment. So speaking on the Eddie and Sammy stuff, she says she has been with Eddie for 10 years and has never seen him like this. She is scared and a little mentally unstable with everything that has been going on between Sammy and Eddie. The worst part of this war is that Eddie won't listen to her or Dreamer. He's lost in his anger, and she fears this isn't the end. She wasn't present when the bat incident happened. She flew out the next day and said that his eye was completely swollen shut. Sammy had never reached out, and he thinks this is a joke. He doesn't take this seriously and is only happy about it because it got people talking. She finishes the call by hyping the match, between Eddie and Sammy that took place this past week's episode of Impact. This was a short call, nothing too crazy here, mostly Josh talking about Slammiversary in the beginning, which I had covered in the beginning. And last but not least, I had spoken last week about the video that Sami Callihan had posted calling out Chris Jericho and Ring of Honor about not being on the Chris Jericho cruise. Well, Don Callis had responded by saying, "I find myself in an interesting position where maybe for the first time I'm agreeing with Sami Callihan, but I'm not sure why Impact Wrestling is not a part of the Chris Jericho cruise." So after that, Chris Jericho responded with, "Wow, okay, Impact Wrestling, consider yourself invited." So that is huge news in itself. Impact Wrestling getting more views and things like that. This is a big thing that has been going on. And Cage Side Seats had released its latest rumor roundup for this week. This week's report claims that there is a rumor that Impact Wrestling versus Ring of Honor angles will take place at the upcoming Chris Jericho cruise. This could potentially be the start of some type of Impact Wrestling and Ring of Honor partnership. I believe on last week's episode of Ring of Honor TV, Austin Aries had his match. Again, you know, we kind of started off this partnership possibly by Aries showing up there, and this would only further it. I'm looking forward to it. Not much else going on. That's pretty much all I have for you guys this week. Thanks for checking out my video. I will see you guys back probably on Friday for my Impact review. And until then, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.